a virus. We're Neurosis. I'm Steve Von Till.
I'm Scott Kelly. Tonight we're going to try to lead you through our universe a little bit, let you see what we're thinking and reflecting upon, and play you some of our videos. This is a video off of our last album. This is Locust Star.
Something in someone else's art that feels similar to what we're doing, like it's like a common thing or a shared thought, but it's rather than an influence, it's just a, shared experience or something. People tap into the same energies.
You know, music is really our religion, you know, as NEUROSIS. I mean, that's where we've gained our most insight. It's been interpersonal insight and spirituality, you know. Every one of us has had spiritual influences in their life before the band, but the true quest and most of the inward vision has come as a result, one way or another, of what we're doing as a band. You know? I mean, we are a religion, basically, to ourselves. I mean, we do it every day. It's a process that we are constantly working through, you know.
First and foremost characteristic is, what does it make you feel? intense emotion.
Reflection is a really powerful tool, you know, to use. And I've always done it a lot, and we do it a lot. We sit there and we look at what we're doing, and we try to, you know, pick out what the significance of these things are. And we've got our own, like, you know, I mean, we've kind of learned to trust in some things because of the amount of experience that we've had together and the trust, you know. Things like that really open up imperceivable doors, really, for people, you know. It's impossible to explain, really, unless you go through it. Welcome back. We're in Neurosis. We're still here on Virus, and there's still more to come.
We're going to talk some more about our philosophy of music and our new album.
The Times of Grace.
It's definitely a ritual. I mean, every day has the same pattern from beginning to end. Yep. I mean, it's arrive at a location, prepare the space, you know, build the altar, set up the stage. It's the same kind of thing, you know. And slowly, throughout the entire day, you're building your energy up to that peak moment. You know, that hour and a half in which at some point probably even has another peak within that, in which you've channeled all this energy of all day into this one second, this one moment, and then all these other people are there to feed their energy into it too, and then that energy gets blasted to the focus of why we're there.
Some of the archetypal imagery that we'll throw up there are things that people may not even notice as much as they feel it deep in their spirit, you know, so... I mean, honestly, I don't think we've ever used more purely negative imagery than we have of just, like, purely spiritual imagery.
Save me!
experiences in our personal lives with loss, death, and it's something that's probably reflected pretty heavily in our music, you know. And that could be why people come away with that feeling inside. But I would think that it had more to do with their own mortality and everybody's fear of death, you know. And I mean, if we're doing what we're trying to do correctly, then I think that's what really would be happening, you know, is that people would be reflecting upon their own experiences or soon-to-be experience of death, you know. One thing's for sure is isolating yourself isn't really the answer. Isolation is good when you need it, but you can't let it be your crutch, you know, your addiction. You have to put yourself out there, and you have to not be afraid.
Yep, you can't alienate the different parts of yourself, you know, like if you're so caught up in the intellectual side of fear, you know, then you have to dig deeper to your primal self, where your main instinct as an animal, as a being, is to do whatever it takes to survive, you know, and to live. I mean, animals that are more comfortable in their instincts and their place in the universe, you know, don't trip on being afraid to live. They just do it and do what they have to, you know. And when it's for them, when it's time for them to sacrifice their life so that something else can go on, it's done without a second thought, you know. It's just, that's the cycle.
Yeah.
not really a tool as much as it's just like a, I mean, I think it's a pain as a reality for everyone, you know. I mean, there's so much of it inflicted on you from the time you're born until the time you die. I mean, the things you go through, the emotional and the physical, you know, that I think that it's, you know, and people have a tendency to just bury it, you know, and then explode. And if you can come and let a little of it out, or at least touch into it more often, I mean, then you're less likely to explode, you know. It's really, that's really all I'm saying. It's pretty, you know.
All cultures have always had the, you know, the shaman or the god or the prophet who makes the sacrifice or makes the trip to the underworld, you know, in order to come back wiser with more knowledge and wisdom. And that can be true of, you know, confronting your pain, dealing with pain, transcending with pain, or a negative-oriented psychedelic trip. You know, it's all a process of gaining the next level of consciousness, you know, and gaining wisdom.
It's still the same intensity and stuff in terms of the way we feel about our lives, and if anything, we're probably more aggressive in a lot of the ways that we deal with things, but as far as with our music, I mean, geez, you know, we did that, we've done that a lot, we've done a lot of pounding, screaming, banging. And all you gotta grow, you know, as well.
It's also more effective to put the aggression in contrast and in relationship to the more mellow, you know, and the contrasting the dark and light in the music. You know, I think you can actually make the crushing parts a lot heavier when using them sparingly and saving them for when you really need them.
Thank you.
for virus this time. It's been a pleasure being here. We're Neurosis. We hope we shared some insights with you.
Hopefully you enjoyed the show and the other videos that were played. And please check out our new album when it comes out. And we'll see you on tour here in Germany this summer.